certainly rotating chemicals is one thing we've implemented, and harvest weed seed control has been part of that. Make sure that we can utilise our chemistry for as long as possible. My name's Dylan Hirsch. I farm here at Latham in the Midwest WA. About 6,000 hectares, fully cropping. Farming here for about 100 years as a family, so certainly feel at home here. Two main weeds that we're targeting here on our farm have been the same for the last 20 years, and that's ryegrass and wild radish. We've been using very similar chemistry for 20 years, trifluralin being the main one, and so we do have some developing resistance in our ryegrass to that chemical. We started implementing a bit of a simpler system, and it was chaff lining, and immediately noticed some of the benefits in putting the weeds into a line. That led us down the path to be confident in taking the next step, which was purchasing a seed mill with a new header. We went for the Seed Terminator, and so far I've been really happy with how it's run, and it's pretty confident in the results it's given us. We run a John Deere S780 Harvester, and we've got a Draper 740 FD front that we use for canola, lupins and some of our cereals. We also run a Shelbourne Stripper front for a lot of our cereals as well. We run the Seed Terminator using both of those. We've got certainly different settings for running different capacities for the machine. The stripper front is actually quite interesting, works quite well with the Seed Terminator, given that we're actually taking in a lot less straw, which can, in our conditions out here, because we're very dry, can break up in the rotor and go onto your sieves, and that seems to happen with a lot of machines. So by reducing the amount of material we're actually taking in with the stripper front, we find the fuel use to run the Terminator is a lot less than what we normally would with a Draper. Saying that, there's situations where we run both fronts, one's better than the other, and we've find the Terminator works well. While it does restrict capacity in really tough conditions, when it's a bit cooler and moister at the start of harvest, currently it's nice and hot and dry like it normally is out here, and it's we barely notice it's there in days like this. This is our fourth year with the Seed Terminator and our sixth year with Harvest Weed Seed Control. It's actually really difficult to track the absolute benefit, because as much as I've been tempted to turn the Seed Terminator off to leave some control strips to see what we're doing, it's when we're in the swing of things, you want to leave it on and make sure it's doing the job on not only the weeds but the volunteer brain as well. But we are noticing that we're using less passes and less sprays to give us our really good hygiene in our paddock. One of the biggest things we can see is in our volunteers in the summer. So when we have summer storms coming through, we're finding we can get away with spot spraying, whereas others around are still having to do full cut sprays with their sprayer. That's one of the ways we can see it really visually working for us. We've got our weeds down in this farm down to a level where we really have that flexibility of crop rotation that we feel like the majority of our paddocks can go into any particular crop that's going to suit the break of the season, and that's key in this area. In the future, I think we can get to the stage where we can get our weed seeds down enough that we can start dropping some of our chemical use down a substantial amount. I think we're a long way away from it there, but the implement of some of the technologies like this and other Australian-made technologies that we see in the future, I think is going to get us there, and yeah, I can't wait to be part of that.
Absolutely, bro.
No worries.
Thank you so much for standing in the sun.
The flies actually weren't as bad as have been otherwise, so we got away with it.